feeling that his Diddy could have a great chance against Ray, as well as his Luigi was looking super sharp. So I'm actually really excited. Like, I didn't think it was going to be close the last time they played, and he just was, like, going in, like, going crazy. So
was Grand Final Set 2 close, or was
No, it was actually really bad. It looks like Raid made the adjustments and life from there. But,
well, they only got one set to deal with
here.
And
so
then who knows what happens.
Not allowing Raid to have four games to adjust, you know. Maybe Grand Finals might be a little different story. But right here, I think this is his best shot, because then it will allow him to go into Grands. And then even if he gets reset, that gives him time to adjust. Or he can just take the next set just straight up. So we'll see how it goes. Going his Luigi off the start. I'm assuming FD is not the pick. Don't do this to me. Okay,
I mean,
FD,
yeah, considering you said that he chose Diddy for the counter pick of FD, I can't imagine that he would strike
like,
to FD.
I was like, no, don't do
that.
That
would be a bit of a confusing turn of events. But all right, we've got Rayquaza versus Low One, our two PR members here, I believe.
Yep, not PR eligible today, sadly, but a little smaller turnout, like we said. But, you know, definitely still great talent, for sure.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and Low One was off to a pretty good start, then got hit.
Yeah, that's all it kind of takes, right?
Fireball.
So I'm going to not sugarcoat this at all. This might be a little longer of a match. And sometimes, you know, Low One Ray can be longer. And I'm not going to say boring.
I love timeouts. If we get any timeouts, I'm going to be in heaven.
Okay, so this is your kind of match then.
I love it.
You just like the strategic value behind it?
I do.
I love the last minute of a timeout. Like, that's the greatest thing ever. But getting there is rough.
I don't know. I like watching neutral game exchanges, and that's all timeout games are pretty much.
Yeah, it's like get your hit and then, like, not necessarily run, but figure out where your next hit's coming from.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh, but yep, Rayquaza gonna find the hit there, and then gets the grab and the balloon. That's clutch. That's definitely needed. Get that out of the way. But actually, kind of just backs off, gets his Luma back. He kind of faked that pressure on Low One. It looked like. You know, just even Rosalina jumping feels like pressure.
Yeah.
It's so scary.
Rosalina's a very scary character.
But Low One, getting rid of Luma, making Rosalina a little less scary. Not by much. I mean, actually, it's quite considerable.
I would say Rosalina without Luma is actually, like, not even a good character.
Right. It's relative, like, oh, wow. Low One going a little too low. The mash not being strong enough to get him back to the stage.
Yeah, it looks like he didn't.
It's sometimes hard to mash that. It's not the easy. And, like, I guess Low One's kind of known for the lack of mash, so makes a little bit of sense. And that's a Ray special right there. Just sitting on the platform waiting, grabs you, the back air, puts you in a bad position.
All right, so Low One's got to do a bit more work. I guess if they could get, if you could gimp.
Yeah, that'd be, like, the thing what he's looking for. Or, like, you know, Low One being such a good player, he probably understands how to play against Rose off stage. Just got to get him there.
Yeah.
And that's what we're going to be looking for. I've also seen him, you know, do the spot dodge Shoryu on Ray before. So, you know, we got some options here. I hate that spinning. You can't do anything, man. Like, I swear.
Yeah.
You can't do anything.
Honestly, should he just, like, chase down Rosalina at that point?
Yeah, I guess so. But, like, you know, everybody's kind of got the thing installed in their head where it's like, kill Luma.
Yeah.
So, ooh, great back air.
All right. Not kill quite
sparks.
Enough to kill.
Yeah, almost. We're getting probably one more. Ooh, how do we get back from the ledge? Yeah, Rayquaza ledge guarding. Very, very scary.
Yeah.
You know, having Luma to cover different options as well as just, you know, Rosalina.
Okay, yeah. He focused a little bit too much on Luma there. Tried to go for the up smash. Got punished for it.
Yeah, Ray realizing and kind of baited his Luma, which was, you know, normally something you don't see from Rosa's, but very smart. But the jab coming out, putting Ray in a bad position. Let's see. Yeah, see, this is what I'm talking about, though. He's not scared to jump down there and figure out. It forced even Ray just to be in a tech spot, a tech situation. Like, why not? You know, free damage. If he techs it, he techs it.
Yeah.
And if he doesn't, I get a kill.
Yeah. Failed ledge trump there, but he does get the tornado, which is, well, he's off stage.
Yeah, off stage. Platform kind of showing up for Rayquaza there. Called the taxi real quick. And then, yeah, I was going to say, he's just waiting for the drop, but Ray just, you know, being patient.
Yeah, Ray's a very patient player.
Oh, and the forward throw, gonna take it. 165 is about time.
Yeah, I didn't know Luigi forward throw even killed, but I guess 165, there's not a whole lot that doesn't.
Yeah, I was gonna say, probably like most tilts at that point are getting pretty close, but great up-y there, catching. Make sure not to get too framed or anything of that sort, but Ray just gonna hang out on the ledge here.
Yeah, Low One did a pretty good job getting back on stage, and now we're just seeing.
Ray has no problem staying on that ledge right now, 2 minutes, 14 seconds. Mm-hmm. Like, that's not an issue for him. He has a pretty substantial, percent lead.
Good job getting rid of Luma pretty quickly, though.
Yeah, that's definitely something Low One needs to do, and that's going to allow him to put a little pressure on. Ray's going to feel it. He's going to be in shield just a little more.
It doesn't seem like the fireballs are really working out too much.
I wonder if he's trying to, throw the fireball. It's rather quick, and then go and run up and punish while he's in the middle. I don't know if you can really punish that move. I don't even know. Ooh, that's the read.
That was ambitious.
Well, that's the read. He maybe understood the percent he was at. He's not going to die. So he just went for the big read right there, and not going to follow through. But if it worked, he'd look like a genius, right?
Yeah. You got to take that gamble sometimes.
Yeah, sometimes going for that, not a big deal. Oh, man, yeah. Ray going out there. What great recovery by Lil One.
Yeah, that was actually a pretty good mash. Plus the jump also gives you a little bit more forward or upward momentum.
Yeah, it helps you out. You know, if you got the lack of mash, that thing will definitely save you. Oh. You know, 1 minute, 15 seconds here, and Lil One's in quite a big deficit. What do you think he really needs to do? Like, does he need the big read here? Is that what we're looking for? Or
I think he's going to need some big reads or maybe a gimp.
How are you going to gimp a Rosa? Just, like, back throw?
I mean, you could use the toilet.
Oh, yeah, you really could, I guess. I had to think about it. I'm like, the toilet? Like, what are you talking about? But then I thought about the spin. I'm like, yeah, that makes a lot. That makes sense.
All right, yeah, but that's kind of how I thought that would go. Low one kind of had a lot of pressure to approach at that point.
Yeah, with 1 minute left. I mean, less than 1 minute, right? Yeah. Like, that's
a
lot.
With that much of a deficit.
Yeah, down 60%. You got to make something happen at that point. Mm-hmm. Which Lil One has no problem going that last minute. Has a lot of faith that he can win those situations because he does often. But against Ray, he has just as much faith in that situation. So, like.
So, last time they played was game one of set one of Grand Finals. Did Lil One win that?
Yes. Okay. He had the momentum going in and then got counterpicked to FD. And then he went Diddy and won that.
Okay.
Then Ray made a little bit of an adjustment. Encounter picked something else, and Lil One lost that, and then actually ended up winning the fourth game.
Okay.
So
we're seeing something like that. No FD. We're going to Town and City, staying Luigi.
Yeah, Luigi will be his bread and butter in this matchup until FD appears, which probably means Lil One won that last map. So, but till that moment, wow, Luma already dead. You can tell by the pathetic yell. I gotta give Luma crap. Like this character beats me at every tournament I go to.
It's a little baby star. What do you want?
It's so good though. It's a little baby that can kill you at like 60%. Like look at that.
It drinks its milk. Okay.
Yeah. No. It definitely has all the calcium it needs. But Lil One, you know, gonna maybe make the adjustments to get in. Definitely starting off better, but that was a very scary moment right there.
Yeah, Luma up air, if you're that close, especially in Town and City, it can kill you at ridiculously low percents.
Yeah, like even I even think, you know, that percent right there was death, like probably death if Luma would have hit Lil One.
I'm not sure, maybe, but either way.
Very scary, nonetheless. Yeah. Oh, let's see, Lil One trying to figure out how to get around the Luma. Oh!
Oh, no tech.
And that's the scary part about the down air from Rosalina. It can send you literally any direction. So sends you down, you die. Sends you right, it's a bad angle. If sends you left, you have at least a tech scenario, but you kind of don't always expect it.
Yeah.
But great things. You know, a back air out there would be a really close to get a kill. So
yeah, that's
putting on the pressure.
Especially with this. Oh, nobody's teching today.
Yeah, no techs. They made a deal before the game started. No techs, all right? But even game now. Lil One punishing the recovery that most people don't punish, sadly.
Yeah, I mean, there's no hitbox on Rosalina up B, so it's...
It's pretty free, but, like, Rayquaza has great mix-ups for it, right?
Yeah.
Like, he makes you hold shield at ledge because he likes to up air through the stage. Then if you realize if you're going to hold... If you've done it so many times, then he just grabs it for free because you're holding shield. And, you know, you kind of got to go out there like Lil One did.
Yeah, conditioning, mix-ups.
Yeah, it's... There's a whole art behind it. But Luma dead.
Luma dead and with a 1% lead.
Time him out. Wow, the 4B is very ambitious. Great grab right there. Let's see. You know, Lil One obviously not going to want to get hit by that down air again. That was a horrible scenario for him last time, but going to get back to stage and, you know, put a little pressure on Rayquaza. And, you know, I noticed Lil One goes for a lot of jabs. Like, jab on Luigi and Mario, kind of super, especially Luigi, right? Super good.
I think Mario's actually faster.
Really?
If I'm remembering correctly. But either way, yeah, they both do have, like, frame two jabs. Very good.
Yeah, he throws a lot of jabs. He gets most of his percent from that, and then eventually, you know, finds his kill later. He's not too worried about it, but oh my goodness, the tornado off the top!
In the wise words of Sup, that doesn't work, but I guess it does.
Yes. Yeah, I've heard them say that. That doesn't work, but I guess it does here. And taking the game, Lil One showing, you know, I got this. Town and City being his counter pick, I'll make it.
That did work out for him.
Use it very effectively. Yeah, let's watch this this nice tornado. Down throw to tornado. That looks like it works kind of. There's an air dodge, I think, available there for.
Probably. I know that it's supposed to not work. I think it might be a DI mix-up. I don't know.
Yeah, definitely. There's something about it. You know, it's not as effective and as strong as it used to be. Like,
oh,
that
yeah,
thing
yeah
was broken. Luigi was like, everybody played Luigi because that was so good.
Yeah, Luigi was kind of like where Mario is now.
Yeah, yeah. Everybody had a Luigi, right? Like, well, if game one fails, I can always rely on my Luigi. it's good in every matchup.
I can just down throw to imagination.
Yeah, few characters have that anymore, sadly. Yeah. I mean, not sadly necessarily. I'm pretty sure it's a good thing. But
I mean, I love that Lucas still has it. Anyway,
right, yeah,
game
yeah
three.
We'll ignore
back
that.
Back to Smashville.
Yeah, Smashville's the choice. Went pretty well for Rayquaza on the first game. Allows him to have a little bit of an escape route to wait for his Luma with the platform. So maybe
actually, do they have the gentleman here? Because Rayquaza already won game one.
On this stage.
Yeah, we
yeah, it definitely was gentleman here.
All right. So I guess low one's fairly comfortable that he can do something on this stage if he agreed to come back to it. Or maybe he just doesn't like any of the other stages that Rosalina could go to.
Right, yeah. Going to, like, Battlefield or Dreamland would seem like a hell. I'm sure he banned those. And then yeah, probably banned those. And then she was like, well, you know what? We went down to the last minute last time, and I didn't play that bad, so.
That was definitely doable for him in game one.
Yeah, he was a little too far behind, but if he makes a few adjustments and has the percent lead and then times them out, like, you know, that might be what he's looking for. Ooh, great jab. Wow, jab gonna get Luma off the stage there. Yeah, this is where Ray shines right there.
Yeah, even without Luma, you can still juggle with those up airs really well.
Yeah, more effective with Luma, obviously, but
mm-hmm. Yeah, because you have a second hitbox and it's more powerful.
Yeah.
And Luma's back.
But, you know, Luigi being a character that's so floaty in the air, sometimes you can just outfloat Rosa, which is insane. Like,
yeah.
That's normally not a thing you think of, because a lot of times Ray just keeps floating in the air and you fall
ooh
too fast. I didn't even see it. I looked away.
He tried to come down with a neutral air, the Luigi syndrome, as I've
yes
heard it called,
yeah,
and just got a forward smash for his troubles.
Yeah, that Nair being the safety blanket sometimes for a few characters, Fox, Mario, Luigi. Really good Nair, right? Like, it's so good.
It's
but
a very good Nair. It's a frame 3 Nair, and Luigi's so floaty, so, like, he'll be falling out of combos and then Nair you back.
But Rayquaza understanding that, just gonna up smash him, you said?
Yeah, forward smash.
Forward smash him for his troubles there. But, ooh, good roll behind, gonna get the jab.
Yeah, Low One's already taking a lot of damage on his second stock, though.
Yeah, it's gonna be very difficult for him. You know, probably right here is where he needs to get this kill. Ooh, great tomahawk, but
yeah, he's good, a good attempt.
Yeah, you know, he's got the right idea right there, but Ray.
Oh, that was
the read. That was what he needed.
Yeah, he had that. It was just a little bit off.
I didn't even think it was off. I thought that was it. I'm so sad.
I think if he was facing the other way, that would have hit.
Yeah. Yeah, the spacing probably correct, but just the way he was facing. That's so sad. Ooh, Ray waiting for possibly down air, waiting for Low to air dodge, but Low not going to give it to him. He needs to stock now. Like, it is going to get way out of hand if he doesn't take it. It's already out of hand.
Yeah.
130 while a Rosa Luma still is only 70% on the first stock.
Although the timer has not gone down quite as much as it did in game one, so if he does take the stock, at least he doesn't need to worry about a timeout quite as much.
Yeah, definitely. If he does take the stock, he's going to have a little bit of that rage, you know, not super useful necessarily until Rosa gets a higher percent, but yeah, the clock's not going to be in a minute. You know, like
yeah
that was very difficult for him last time.
Yeah, if he can take it soon, he'll have like 2 or 3 minutes.
What do you think he's looking for? Like a back air, maybe a back throw?
Yeah, I might be going for just trying to get her off stage, and up tilt will take it from not even Luma.
150, I guess that's just, you know, a high enough percent.
Yeah, Rosalina did have a bit of rage, and I don't think that he had used up tilt very much.
At all,
yeah,
actually.
Yeah, because you usually do like up throw, up tilt,
yeah,
like early percents. But
by that time, it just unstales itself. So.
Yeah.
But game three we go. Let's see if Low One can just, you know, win his counter pick.
Game four.
I had to like do the math in my head real quick, but yeah.
So do we just not have Dave's stupid rule here?
I guess we're just not gonna follow that, yeah, because you know Low One definitely did win on this stage.
All right, well.
I mean, okay, real quick though, this is not a bad stage for Rosa though.
No, not at all. Especially with those up air kills, is Yanni trying? Well, okay, so we got confirmation that they are gentlemaning back to these stages.
Okay. Yeah, maybe, you know, Ray doesn't want to play against Diddy.
That could be it, yeah.
Which, as well as this is not even that bad of a map for him.
Yeah.
And just feels, you know, I made the adjustments. Now it's time to show him that I am really good on this map as well.
Or maybe they both just really like Animal Crossing.
Animal Crossing is a great game, so I can't blame them. It makes a lot of sense to me. That's got to be it, actually, you know?
Yeah, probably.
That's definitely what it is.
All right, so Fireballs, not really doing a whole lot against Rosalina.
Yeah, not too much. You know, even when Luma doesn't, like, when you don't gravitational pull them in, Luma just eats them.
Yeah.
And which you don't want Luma to eat them, really, but, you know, that's better than you taking those. Oh, my God, that, like, I thought that might break shield. That was getting really close. But great follow-up
there.
Yeah,
if he had a little bit less shield, that actually might have done something.
That was, yeah, if it would have broke shield, easy stock for him. But Ray holding the shield, realizing, not going to break my shield, and he actually got a great follow-up.
Oh, that was a good down air, too. He didn't get the spike. Ooh, he just got a spike. Yeah.
Yeah, no, it definitely has a spike. Yeah, it hurts. That down there definitely hurts, but yeah.
It did put him at a weird angle.
Yeah, put him at an awkward angle, trying to get that stage spike. I mean, best case scenario is he gets the spike, but Luma right there, kind of just interrupting everything Low One wanted to do.
Oh, up smash.
Confirming that kill. That
yeah, it's like Mario's, he's just at a weird angle, but.
Yeah, it's very similar, right? It's the headbutt, but Luigi kind of leans a little more and reaches, and hey, they're both just as good as each other, I actually think. Now I'm thinking about it, but. Yeah, right. It's like when I think of like Dr. Mario. It's just the angles. That's really all it is.
Yeah, it's like Mario and Wario have it go straight up. Dr. Mario and Luigi send it at a weird angle.
But let's see if Low One can put some pressure in. He's doing
a great job. Yeah, he's getting some damage in. Getting a lot of extra credit. Well, not a lot, but...
Enough.
Getting extra credit.
Yeah, that's what you're looking for just in general. But Low, probably not happy with that. Gonna get the Luma kill. And I like his spacing over when they were on the platforms earlier. Ooh, wow, okay, both air dodges. But they were on the platforms earlier. He kind of got in between Luma and Ray and like, you know, wiggled his way. Oh! But there's the down air we saw earlier.
Yeah, that one not sending at an awkward angle, just sending at the best angle.
Yeah, that is the optimal angle.
The angle you want.
Yeah, got to send him straight down. Two stocks.
So we got game five.
And now this is, do you think they'll gentlemen again?
If they go back to Smashville, it would be amusing.
I would be shocked at this point.
If they do, then I think I'm 100% sure that's just because they like Animal Crossing.
Yeah, no, at this point, because it's definitely not good for Low. Like, we're kind of learning that down smash.
We're still seeing the replay. So Smashville.
Well, Animal Crossing must be their favorite game, because...
So Low One has won every time on Town City. Rayquaza has won every time on Smashville.
That's why I'm surprised. I mean, at this point, maybe they're just like, you know what, we've been gentlemaning this whole time. It's game five. Like, to them, it's a big deal if they win winners, but they kind of understand that they're probably going to meet in Grands anyways. So... that explanation was horrible, but it was good enough.
Never count anyone out.
No,
okay. Anyway.
Ever.
So, Low One's actually off to a pretty good start in this game.
Yeah, starting off a lot better. Like, last time, every hit of that connected. But last time, he got behind really early. Oh, my God. This is so scary. Okay, he's down. We're good. We're back in this.
It's interesting seeing Low One, like, keep trying to come down directly on Rayquaza. And honestly, it's like it's working out for him most of the time, which is not something you usually advise you to do against someone who juggles as well.
Maybe it's, like I was saying earlier, it's probably just like the awkward fall speed. It's Rayquaza, you know, has to come down and land because like he can't actually outfloat a character for once.
Yeah.
So like he gets the two and then like Luigi can just chill. And then when he's falling to land, he can actually come down and like he comes down with a nair a lot, which I saw in the last set I saw them play, which actually beats a lot of Rosa's options. So maybe that's it. Like that's my best understanding of it. Yeah, trying to get in there while the Luma's dead. Obviously, really smart, but really close game here on game five.
Yeah, it is pretty much dead even.
Yeah, they're a lot better than the first two times on Smashville for sure.
Ooh, yeah, especially game three. Which...
Yeah, that was pretty bad. But that dash attack, so goofy. I love it. Yeah, and that's something we haven't seen a lot from Ray either. Is that that crouch?
Oh, okay. Went for the air dodge read, drifted a little bit too far, and Rayquaza is on his last winner's bracket stock.
Yeah, you definitely, if you were here at the venue, you definitely see him moving his front of seat a little bit, readjusting. Kind of shocked, died, but, you know, maybe we'll see the angry Ray.
Oh, okay. Yeah, there's his down air spike.
Yeah, that was like the softest of down air spikes, but it's just still too far down for you to do anything.
Yeah, Rosalina's got a weird one, though, where like you can get the sweet spot or you can get the soft spot. They both send you down. They're both just not something you want to get hit by.
Yeah, the down air just in general, you know, sending you all different directions, just getting hit by is like a mix-up in its own. And it's like something Ray can't necessarily even control sometimes. So you're just like, do I get stage spike this time? Do I go down? Do I go right? Sometimes you go up and you're like, thanks, like, sick. But yeah, Ray using this platform really effectively. Every time he's gone to Smashville, he uses the platform really well.
All right, Low One choosing his pressure, like You saw he went for the jab on Luma, did not finish it just so they wouldn't get grabbed. That time he did go for the jab finisher, he did get grabbed.
Yeah, just mixing up his jab option as well, you know, really smart. And that's something that Ray loves to do a lot is he sees people fully jab on Luma and he will just run and grab you every time.
Yeah.
Even though as Luma takes damage, he makes sure he at least gets a punish of his own. And,
yep.
You know, that punish sometimes is even better because he's actually doing percent to you comparatively to a Luma that respawns every 12 seconds. So, 13.
Is it 13 now?
I don't 12.
I know it was really short when the game first came out, and then they patched it.
Yeah, I think it was like, yeah, it was really short off the start. It was like 7 or something like that.
It was really bad. Yeah, it was ridiculous. Anyway, low one with a little bit of a lead here, coming down with the Luigi syndrome.
Yeah, you know, the Nairs. Sometimes.
Yeah, they're actually working out for him really well, though.
Yeah, they're definitely not getting as punished as heavily as last time, but last time Ray punished it was like a kill punish, right?
Yeah, it was like sort of like that Little Mac, like cockback, smash.
Yep, exactly. So, you know, realizing like forward smash probably not too safe an option here, even if he gets the read. Did that Nair just clink with up smash? Is that what I just saw? Like, that is nuts. But low one with this huge percent lead definitely has Rayquaza on the ropes a little bit. No Luma, 100%. Does Lomon actually take this, I wonder?
He could. It's very doable.
This is very, very doable.
Though Rayquaza is not to be underestimated.
No, even at 63%, you know, yeah. Yeah, right there was super good. Just waiting for the perfect option.
Yeah, that could have been it.
I thought that was actually going to be it, but not yet. Back to the platform we go for Ray. 145 on the clock. I don't think this will go to a timeout, but I mean.
It honestly, it might. Like,
if it keeps playing like this.
If we keep seeing this, it could. I don't blame Low One going for it. He's got the lead. It doesn't really matter. Like, if Rayquaza wants to keep absorbing fireballs, that's his business.
Yeah, that's his prerogative at this point. Because, I mean, maybe waiting for his time to go in, wait for one little aggressive option from Low One and punish it on that platform.
Yeah, just that little bit of damage on Luma.
But finally found the aggressive option, came off the platform to punish, but didn't connect. But that was an awkward angle to be sent at.
Yeah, Luma Nair, really, really weird.
Yeah, Rosalina as a character can just send you in so many different awkward angles. And this jab is so scary. Jab 3 on Luma, one of the more intimidating jab 3s.
Oh. That was a very aggressive up smash.
Ooh, okay, minute left now. You know, the lead isn't as much as it was previously.
Oh! And Rayquaza.
Low One gonna take it.
Low One takes it.
Yeah, Rayquaza not too happy about that, but Low One gonna take it. I'm sure we'll see them probably in grands. Is this Yanni going for third place right now?
Yeah, our loser semis.
Loser semis. I'm sorry, yeah.
Fourth place.
So, you know, great match by Low One.